Is that something that you think would be of value to you? Okay, no, well, and then if you know, Soto throws out an objection, like the reason why anyone that wants to buy right away, don't try to like schedule a call, pencil some bullshit in, pick up the phone and call. And you can literally get the feedback, get what he needs or she needs, overcome any objection right away, and then get the deal done. Like, you got to buy, ready to buy. Don't extend the sales cycle. You're not going to squeeze out any more juice.
Hey, everybody. Jorge Soto here, and you're watching Demo Diaries. Today, I'm joined by my friend, Brandon Bornancin, who is best-selling author. I got to say that, Brandon, and CEO at Seamless.AI. Brandon, how are you, man? Good to see you.
Hey, doing great, man. Super excited to be here to chat about demo and demo diaries.
Absolutely. Well, let's kick it off. Let's just go straight to the point. Yeah. Based on your experience, you work with some of the best and brightest sales reps and sales organizations, you know, on earth. And what would you say is one of the reasons, or maybe a couple reasons, why salespeople just suck at demos? A lot of folks.
Yeah. And I wouldn't blame it on the salespeople, you know, because like one, we've got amazing salespeople. We've got amazing sales products. I think it's the training and the lists that are probably the two biggest areas that are missing. But if I would teach someone how to generate $1 million in sales insanely fast using the perfect demo pitch formula, my first tip would be tonality, personality, excitement, and passion right out of the gate. And we've done no prep for this call, right? So I'm going to kind of share a few secrets. Yeah. You know, my book, Sales Secrets. I love giving out sales secrets, right? So my first secret to mastering the demo, got to come out of the gate. You know, Jorge, hey man, congrats on all the success at Reprise. Love everything you're doing for the demo personalization automation space. You're changing the game. It's absolutely epic. Thrilled to chat with you today. How's everything going over there? So like that excitement versus, hi John, it's Brandon here at Seamless.AI. Yes, we are on a Zoom. Could you please okay. It looks like you're off of mute. Okay. Are we waiting for anyone else there? Are we waiting for anyone? Soto over there? Oh, okay, cool. You're like totally different dynamic. So step one, energy, tonality, passion, and confidence right out of the gate. And that sets the stage. And then we got probably 10 other secrets we can go into.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, what about, so I guess, let me take a step back, and that's the beginning. That's like developing the rapport and those sort of things. What about like discovery? Cause you know, there's been a lot of discussion around, hey, do we do just pure discovery on call one, or do we do a hybrid where we'll do a little discovery and then we go into a demo and then maybe we're sort of doing through the conversation.
My second secret was you have to be a master at sales discovery. And that's, there's like 1,000 secrets in sales discovery, but step one, sales discovery, like the way that we've mastered sales discovery, I can ask you 7 questions or less and know everything about where you're at, where you need to go, the gap, and what we could provide to get you from point A to point B, you know, from zero to millions of dollars in sales. If you're at millions of dollars in sales to $100 million in sales, like I've got it dialed into 7 questions or less. But the way that I got to those 7 critical discovery questions was my team and I, we listed out 100 different sales discovery questions, and then we prioritized and ranked them. A scale of 1 to 10, 10 being most important, 1 being a complete waste of fucking time for your prospect. Like, so you score all of your, you know, your sales discovery questions. So step one, I call it outline, mind map, right? Like outline, what are all the possible sales discovery questions that you could have? Throw it against the wall, get in a Google sheet, then let's score it. Most important to learning to provide a customized recommendation and solution to the prospect, to one, complete waste of their time. And then once you have that, you just keep trying to drill it down, 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 and down to get to as little discovery questions as possible to uncover the pain, the problem, the goals, the solutions, the responsibilities, the KPIs, the ROI, the revenue, or whatever their goal is, time saving, revenue, IT, speed, whatever. And then from there, like the next set of secrets, once you've got your sales discovery questions dialed in, is like intently listening, shutting the fuck up, recording that, transcribing it. I also, you have to have all of your discovery questions in your Salesforce. Like, I don't let my reps save discovery questions anywhere but Salesforce. So we have massive text input fields. Each sales discovery question is in Salesforce. This saves all of your reps forgetting to input stuff, missing feedback, missing Q&A, missing learnings. It's all just saved on the account in sales discovery, right in your CRM. They have to fill that in on the discovery calls, and then they'll never forget what to ask, how to ask it. And it's just really like the difference between great reps and bad reps. They ask the discovery, they put themselves on mute, they listen, they take notes in their CRM of all those answers. And then they could take the what they learned from discovery and then customize the presentation based on that. But before we get into the presentation customizing and the demo customizing, let's talk about any questions on those tips for sales discovery.
Yeah, how much discovery or how many of those questions can be answered? Actually, I have a couple. Could be answered before the call. So being able to use like tools like yours and other intelligence or insights tools. So that's my first, you know, part of the that section or question of that around that section. The second one is, how do the questions change, or do they based on the buying persona?
Yeah, I would say you could do a ton of research, right? Everything about the company. Who's the company? What do they do? Who are they competing with? You've got all this pitch intel from a platform, you know, from our platform, Seamless.AI, LinkedIn, other data sources out there. Then you can get a ton of data about the person that you're meeting with, the people that could potentially be on the buying committee, and you can get all that data in an instant. Like, you know, build a list of everyone at that account in seconds with Seamless, LinkedIn, whatever, have all of those insights into your CRM. But really understanding like what's the biggest thing holding them back from where they're at today to where they want to go. Some of that data you just have to ask and you have to drill into. So don't ask the non-bullshit, who are your competitors? What do you sell? What do? Like, you know what they do. Like for us, the VP of sales, if I was like, oh, so what do you do over there? Like if someone asked my VP of sales that question, he'd want to punch him in the face, respectfully. Like, it's just the dumbest question that you could ask. It's like, hey, I know you're the VP of sales. You can make assumptions. I know that you've got a sales team of 100 sales reps. I know that your quota, you're trying to drive $100 million in sales this year based on what I saw on LinkedIn. Mm-hmm. What is the number one thing holding you back from getting to 100 million this year? Mm. And then mute yourself, take it all in, right? So definitely research as much as possible in advance, and then only ask the questions that you know you can't cover anywhere else. It's like absolutely critical. Just boom, 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 mute yourself, transcribe that, save it in your CRM, and you're good to go.
Awesome. Awesome. Good stuff. Well, let's talk about the actual presentation. What tips and the best practices do you have about that around that step?
Yeah, my first tip is, you know, if you're pitching to someone like me that has limited time, limited availability, I'm in 20 meetings a day I work from 4:45 a.m. to 10 p.m. If you are a rep that forces me to do a discovery, then do a presentation meeting, then get pricing, I will hate you forever. Like, don't customize the pitch based on the persona. You know, for example, like, I'm going to call some companies out, like Gong. To get a quote from Gong, I had to do a discovery call. Then I have to do a presentation. Then I have to get a quote. It's like, dude, you guys know it's $150 a month per license. Like, I'm calling. I already know you guys are one of the best in the world. How much is it per license? What's the minimum? And I don't need you to show the value of the value of the value. I'm telling you, I'm a buyer. I'm ready to buy. So they missed our deal. I had a window where they had my attention. I was ready to buy and they blew it because Brandon, no, we need to do discovery call. Brandon, no, we need to do demo. Brandon, no, we need to show you ROI. I'm like, guys, I don't need any of that bullshit. I'm ready to buy right now. So my first tip is like, listen to your buyers and literally like hear their process. Don't try to shove your process down their throat. And I got a lot of respect for Gong and the people over there are awesome. It's just the instant example that came together quickly. There's been a ton of other software that we've tried to buy where, you know, you have to do a discovery. They won't give you pricing. It's like, guys, like, you know, the ranges of your pricing. If someone's interested in pricing, yes, they try to say, oh, you have to build value first. Like, give them pricing. Hey, you know, look, we haven't done discovery. We haven't shown you the results you could drive, but our products are $5,000 to $10,000 a month, annual commit. And wait till we put together the ROI and the strategic execution plan. You're going to make 4 to 10x that on your money. So like you can answer these things and answer these questions in advance without like, I don't know, a lot of people will say, don't do this. Don't disclose this. I think it's stupid. Mm-hmm. Like we're all humans. We're all buyers. Like if someone wants pricing, give them pricing. Totally. If someone wants the pitch and demo and discovery in one call, do it in one call. If you can, like some high ticket, 100K, 1 million, like I sold for IBM and Google. At IBM, I was selling multi-million dollar website redesigns. That's not a one call, 15, 10 minute discovery, 10 minute presentation, 10 minute close. Totally different mm-hmm. when you're doing a $30 million, $50 million website redesign or a custom AI IBM Watson program. Totally different. But for the normal stuff, the medium to low ticket, you could do in one call. And the presentation, got to customize. Customize it all for what you learned. So if Seamless.ai, you know, we deliver the world's best sales leads, find cell phones and emails for anyone in seconds. If you and I, if I'm pitching you, like, I'm going to try to learn what's the thing that you care about most. You know, what do you use the most? What's your biggest pain point? And then I'm going to take our presentation and let's just say you're like, hey, I just need everyone that's looking like I need all the account executives who pitch all the time for Reprise so that I could get in front of them. And I only want to live in Salesforce. Okay, well, look, Seamless lives in Salesforce, Gmail, on any website, in our web app. Like, I'm not going to worry about showing you all of that bullshit. I'm going to go into, hey, here's how you do a search to find all the account executives, their perfect email, cell phones, and insights. Here's how you get it auto-imported to Salesforce. Here's how you could see and live just in Salesforce 24/7. Here's the ROI revenue results. And here's the pricing. What objections do you have? Mm. So it's being very methodical about what you present and presenting everything back to where they're at today, their pain, solving their pain to getting them to where they want to go tomorrow to be successful. And then the returns and the ROI and the business case that they could get from that. I've done demos where we've closed deals in 3 minutes. I've done demos where they don't even see the platform. We're on the phone. I'm telling them what it does. They're like, cool, send me the contract. I'm like, okay, I'm going to send you the contract. I'll wait on the line. They sign. They've never seen it before. Mm. Like that's when you know you're doing good discovery, presentation, closing. Doesn't happen all the time, right? But I don't worry about, oh, I got to do discovery on one call. I got to do a demo on another call. I got to present pricing on a third call. I always customize it. Like because I sell to VPs of sales and they're brutal. They will beat the shit out of you, you know? Mm-hmm. Like they will destroy you. They're like venture capitalists. They will rip you apart and try to spit you out. No offense to VCs. I've worked with a lot of them. And I got a lot of respect for both VPs of sales and VCs, but like their time is limited. They need the answers right now. And, you know, you just got to just give it to them the way that they want it.
Totally. I totally get it. And, you know, that reminded me of an interaction I had recently where I won't say the name of the provider, but it was a social media platform that all of us know were already using it. And I was writing them to upgrade, to get more seats. And of course, the salesperson pushes back and says, let's do a call, you know? And I'm like, no, I don't need a call.
I don't need a call.
I just need it to upgrade, right? Like, sorry, I just don't. And I
You're
said,
like, look, I just need five more sales.
That's all I need. Exactly. I literally replied and said that. I just need whatever. I think it was five more seats, yeah. same feature set. What do you think he said?
Well, let's jump on a call. You know, I want to make sure I really understand what you're trying to accomplish. Exactly. Guys, when you do that bullshit, first off, first thing you should do there, that guy screwed or woman, whoever, that salesperson screwed up. I'm calling you in 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Right away, I'm picking up. Hey, man, first off, I want to say thank you and congratulations. Truly appreciate your interest in expanding your business with us. Mm-hmm. Quick run through. How many people are on your team? You've got five. You said you need five. Awesome. Do you need the enterprise level of sales nav or do you just need the basic one that you're currently on? Do you know the difference? Because maybe you don't know the difference. Hey, the enterprise one will integrate with your CRM and it'll also give you team insights to accounts. Is that something that you think would be of value to you? Okay. No. Well, and then if you know, Soto throws out an objection, like the reason why anyone that wants to buy right away, don't try to like schedule a call, pencil some bullshit in, pick up the phone and call. And you can yep. literally get the feedback, get what he needs or she needs, overcome any objection right away, and then get the deal done. Like you got to buy, ready to buy. Don't extend the sales cycle. You're not going to squeeze out any more juice.
Brandon, you're going to cry when I tell you what his response was next.
Oh yeah, let's hear it.
So I'm like, I actually wrote a blog post about this. I shared it on LinkedIn.
You're probably so pissed. I was so pissed with that stuff.
I was so upset. And, you know, I also like, I don't know. It's just like, didn't make any sense. So I said, listen, dude, I just don't have a time for a call. Can you just send me the link or whatever? I'm a buyer. I'll buy now. And then he replies back with, well, you know, the, some excuse. And then he's like, well, here's the link to my calendar. And
oh my God.
Here's the thing. I'm out of office tomorrow. But I'm free Thursday. This is like Monday. And I'm going to burn a week. Are you kidding me? Yes. So I just gave up. I literally gave up. And I'm like, I just can't. I need a couple of days to just, you know, sort of revisit if I want to work with this vendor. Because as I scale, you know, we continue to add heads. I can't deal with this kind of stuff.
We got to get you on Seamless. You're going to love it. But dude, that you see how fast you lose someone, you know, like...
Yeah.
Why didn't you just pick up the phone? It would have taken you the same amount of time to send, well, book an appointment with me, sending that email, pick up the damn phone. You were ready to go engaged. I could have texted you. Hey, you got 1 second right now. Boom. Like if you hit me that you're ready to buy. Like I had this guy, I was on a podcast, an author, number one best-selling national author. He's like, I want to demo a Seamless. Okay, what's your calendar link? Here's my calendar link. I literally sent it to my top AI. I say, give him VIP treatment, get him locked and loaded. He's eager to get started with the platform, rock and roll. Done. You got to move fast and cut the
move
bullshit.
Fast. I know,
cut
4 days?
So this is where Keenan and I, it was funny because Keenan was my mentor like a decade ago. And I always talk about gap selling, not his book, but like the strategy of, you have to figure out like when you're doing enterprise sales and even when you're doing high transaction sales, Seamless.ai, we acquired tens of thousands of customers by figuring out where you at today. Where do you want to go? What is the gap? How do we help you fill the gap to go from point A to point B? But Keenan will not let you give pricing or do any of that stuff until you have a multi-step demo approach. I'm just like, my man, I love you, but that is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You customize the demo process with the people that you're working with. If I've got 2 minutes, I've got millions of dollars and I can buy in 1 minute, I want to know what it can do. In another minute, I want the business case and ROI. And in the third minute, I want pricing proposal. I will tell you yes or no, because I make decisions insanely fast. I'm a buyer that doesn't fucking overanalyze anything. It's like, if it makes sense, it makes money, done, I'm in.
Yep. I totally get it. It reminds me of my door-to-door sales days and my training where we were trained to never give pricing until the end during like my closing statement. And the reason why, and I understand the psychology, it's like, oh, well, you don't want them to make a decision just based off of pricing, right? That's a consumer transaction though, right? Like it's a very different sort of transaction. What we're talking about here is a business B2B transaction. And even in the consumer one, the world has changed. So I totally get
B2B
it. B2B
right? Or B2C, like literally, you know, let me give you another example. And this isn't to flex. This is just a real world example. I worked 7 days a week. I was fried Saturday morning in the summer. It was beautiful last summer. I'm like, I call my brother-in-law. I'm like, dude, I'm fried mentally. I've been working for like 21 days straight. Let's go drive some fucking sports cars. So we drive up to this place called the Toy Barn. I'm in Columbus, Ohio. They've got all the coolest exotics in the world. I'm not on the market at all. One of my dream cars was an Audi R8. I drive in there. I'm like, hey man, I want to test drive an Audi R8. I've never done it before. I test drive it. I hate it. And then I'm like, hey, you know, what other cool sports cars do you have? They're like, oh, we've got this brand new Ferrari. I was like, dude, I've never been in a Ferrari. I'm like, how much is it? He's like, oh, it's, you know, 220,000, whatever the price was at the time. Right. And I'm like, cool. You know, do you care if I test drive it? He's like, you got proof of funds? And I'm like, yeah. Boom. He's like, okay, cool. Test drove it, literally bought on the spot. I test drove it, loved it, bought on the spot. That morning, I did not wake up saying I was going to buy a Ferrari. I was going to buy anything, but like found something I wanted, got the price right away. And I saw the value. I'm in. Same goes with software. Like I've bought multi-million dollar software, same approach, $100 software, same approach. Like if you analyze it, really smart people can analyze the value insanely fast. And by the way, if you're a salesperson, you can deliver the value in 1 minute. You don't need to wait 60 minutes to deliver the value, you know?
Yeah, totally. Brandon, thank you so much. I know we're up on the hour here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You're always so gracious with your time. I know you work 7 days a week and are doing amazing things. If folks want to follow you on social media, maybe learn more about your books, what are some great URLs or handles to reach you?
Yeah, definitely. So if you join Seamless.AI for free and you use the referral code Sales Secrets, you'll get my new number one bestseller, Sales Secrets, absolutely free. We've interviewed 100 plus sales experts, 1,000 secrets, and you'll be able to get cell phones and emails for anyone in the world at seamless.ai. That's seamless.ai. And then hit me up, follow me on LinkedIn. I'm capped out on connections, but I post daily there and I engage with everyone that comments, likes, subscribes. So would love to see you and connect. And I hope this session was of value. I want to give you guys a different perspective that people are scared to share, won't share, will be too political to share. I don't worry about any of that. I want to tell you, hey, this is how I sold over $100 million in sales. This is how I raised over $100 million in funding and the no bullshit strategy that we've used to make it happen. So I hope it's of value to you.
Thank you so much, brother. Virtual hug. Love you, man. And hope to see you in person soon.
I haven't seen you, man,
in person in a while.
Thank you so much for having me. Truly appreciate it. And you guys are crushing it. Good luck.
Thank you. Have a good one.